Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview. Dallas, I got a great way to help you with your resolutions. We called in some experts today, and they're going to help us with those resolutions, I think, that have fallen by the wayside. I've got Dr. Gary Foster, who's here to give us some information, and Chef Eric. Thank you guys for joining us today on the Valder Beebe Show.
Thanks for having us.
Pleasure.
All right. Dr. Foster, will you set the understanding for us of your connection with Weight Watchers?
I'm the chief science officer at Weight Watchers. It's a really great position because you get to leverage the science that we create and others create to really help our members to develop healthy habits for the real world.
So it's not just something that they advertise that they want you to go on this diet, because any diet, you'll lose weight. That's what I found out.
Yeah, I think that's a really, really true statement. Then that's why in January, and this is one of the things that I think is a call out for people to be on the lookout, that in January, it's very appealing to think, I'm going to do this really rigid approach, whether it's no sugar, keto, no this, no that. That's got strict rules, and it may be appealing for a few minutes or a few days or a few weeks. But in the long term, people like to eat foods. You don't have to You don't have to leave your life to lose weight. You can actually do both. So at this time of year, people are reevaluating and saying, I get that initial appeal, but I can't do this for the long term. What's a plan I can stick to?
That's true. And Chef Eric, your connection with Weight Watchers.
I'm a member, first and foremost. You know, I mean, for years, I've always been focused on delicious, and I've always had a love for food. But, you know, that love for food eventually started to dwindle and be replaced by a challenge. You know, my life became challenging, and I wanted to get that love for food back. And so I became a member and eventually became a brand ambassador. And it's about, you know, having a flexible program. I mean, look, I eat for a living. And so I have to have something that I can have choice and still live a healthy lifestyle, you know, and it works. In the last year, I've lost over 50 pounds.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank
to you.
You.
Dr. Foster, I'm not going to ask you why people tend to give up their resolutions, because you've already answered that. You can't do something unless, to me, it becomes a part of your life. So I'll ask you, what is the key for making lasting habits and make them work for us?
Yeah, as you mentioned, it's really about the approach. One of the things that we say frequently at WW, the new Weight Watchers, is that it's about progress, not perfection. So as a result, we embed in our program the reality that people don't eat the same on a Monday night as they do on a Saturday night. And that kind of flexibility and livability is really important to us and to our members as we develop the program. We also have features in our program that give people over 200 zero-point foods and that don't have to be weighed, measured, or tracked. So it just makes the program a lot more livable and sustainable in the long term. And as a result of being rooted in behavioral science and being obsessed with developing a program that's both flexible and livable, I'm happy to report that our freestyle program is the most effective and livable program in our long history.
Oh, that's exciting. Chef
yeah.
Eric, since you are a member of Weight Watchers,
I am.
But you are also guiding people to have better understanding of eating. Tell me some of your simple meal planning.
I mean, for me, look, I'm never going to sacrifice flavor. I'm never going to sacrifice delicious. And I think it's important for a sustaining habit to be something that you want to eat, right? But you can focus on those 0-point foods that the doctor pointed out and really incorporate them in really fun and exciting ways. Like, for example, I've got this macaroni and cheese in our cookbook, Cook Up Comfort. And look, you're gonna put macaroni in it, right? But you can stretch that macaroni and get that texture and flavor, but stretch it with cauliflower to make it more filling and a little bit of a healthier choice. And the cheese sauce isn't just cream and cheese. It's roasted squash. It's non-fat Greek yogurt, which are two of my favorite Zero Point foods, and you blend those together with like a really strong flavored cheese, and it stretches that cheese flavor and yet makes it healthy. You know, for me, it's also about being a part of a community. I think that's the best hack. I mean, for me, WW has that app. It's so easy to use, and it helps you track. But it's got Connect on it, which kind of brings together the entire community. And when you've got people in your corner kind of sharing ideas with you and helping you along in the journey, that's what really makes this thing work.
All right, then. I'm going to take a Facebook question because I thought this was quite interesting. Dr. Foster, they want to know if you're giving Oprah any advice.
Oprah gives us a lot of advice. She's a member, she's a thought leader, and obviously she gives us tons of inspiration. So she's a very active member of our board and is very close to not only where we are now, but where we're going in the future. So it's so fantastic to have her part of our leadership team and our board and her giving us great direction.
Thanks so much for that. Eric, let me ask you. So we are coming up on Valentine's Day. Any suggestions for us? You know, because, you know, we try to go off our diets on or our lifestyles on holiday.
Yeah, I mean, I think that, like, always focus on the big picture, right? Like, it's okay to have a celebratory experience like Valentine's Day and not really sweat the small stuff and just enjoy and have a great luxurious experience, and then get back on the train the next day. But I'll tell you, you know, one of my favorite Zero Point foods that's perfect for Valentine's Day, oysters.
Oh.
Yeah. Oysters. It's perfect for both.
So you can eat as many as you want?
Eat as many as you want. I mean, within reason, like you couldn't eat as many oysters as you'd need to eat to get it out of within the realm of reason, but it's an aphrodisiac, so be careful out there.
Chef Eric, Dr. Foster, thank you so very much. And where can we go online, Dr. Foster, get more information about Weight Watchers?
It's a pretty easy one. It's www.com, and you can find all the information that you need.
Thank you guys so very much. Check in with us real soon to see how my audience is doing with those resolutions. Thank you.
Thanks, Father.
Thank you.